Question number 91. Which of the following are one of the advantages of running your cloud in a private cloud? Option A. You own the hardware, so you can change private cloud hosting providers easily. Option B. Assurance that your code, data, and applications are running on isolated hardware and on an isolated network. Option C. Private cloud is significantly cheaper than the public cloud. The correct answer is option B. Assurance that your code, data, and applications are running on isolated hardware and on an isolated network. Private cloud provides the advantage of dedicated resources, ensuring that your applications and data are isolated from others, enhancing security and control. This is especially beneficial for organizations with strict compliance or security requirements. Question number 92. Which tool within the Azure portal will make specific recommendations based on your actual usage for how you can improve your use of Azure? Option A, Azure Monitor. Option B, Azure Dashboard. Option C, Azure Advisor. Option D, Azure Service Health. The correct answer is option C, Azure Advisor. Azure Advisor provides personalized recommendations based on your actual usage and configuration in Azure. It helps you optimize your resources in areas like cost management, performance, security, and high availability by analyzing your environment and offering actionable suggestions. Question number 93. What type of document does the Microsoft Service Trust Portal provide? Option A. A tool that helps you manage your compliance to various standards. Option B. A list of standards that Microsoft follows, pen test results, security assessment, white papers, FAQs, and other documents that can be used to show Microsoft's compliance efforts. Option C. Documentation on the individual Azure services and solutions. Option D. Specific recommendations about your uses of Azure and ways you can improve. The correct answer is option B. A list of standards that Microsoft follows, pen test results, security assessments, white papers, FAQs, and other documents that can be used to show Microsoft's compliance efforts. The Microsoft Service Trust Portal provides detailed documentation regarding Microsoft's compliance with various industry standards, including pen test results, security assessments, and white papers. It helps organizations understand Microsoft's security and compliance practices. Question number 94. Why should you divide your application into multiple subnets as opposed to having your web, applications, and database servers running on the same subnet? Option A. Each server type of your application requires its own subnet. It's not possible to mix web servers, database servers, and application servers on the same subnet. Option B. Separating your application into multiple subnets allows you to have different NST security rules for each subnet, which can make it harder for a hacker to get from one compromised server onto another. Option C, there are only a limited number of IP addresses available per subnet. So, you need multiple subnet over a certain number. The correct answer is option B. Separating your applications into multiple subnets allows you to have different NSC security rules for each subnet, which can make it harder for a hacker to get from one compromised server onto another. Dividing your application into multiple subnets enhances security by allowing you to apply different network security group, NSG, rules to each subnet. This segmentation helps limit the movement of potential attackers, reducing the risks of lateral attacks if one server is compromised. Question number 95. Which feature within Azure alerts you to service issues that happen in Azure itself, not specifically related to your own resources? Option A, Azure Service Health. Option B, Azure Security Center. Option C, Azure Monitor. Option D, Azure Portal Dashboard. The correct answer is option A, Azure Service Health. Azure Service Health provides alerts and notifications about service issues happening within Azure itself, such as outages, maintenance, or other incident affecting the Azure platform. It helps keep you informed about issues that might impact the availability of Azure services, even if they are not directly related to your own resources. Just a quick reminder, if you don't want to watch all these videos and instead download all questions and answers, then feel free to purchase them on Buy Me a Coffee page. I have shared the link below. Question number 96. What two advantages does cloud computing elasticity give to you? Pick two. Option A, you can save money. Option B, you can do more regular backups and you won't lose as much when that backup gets restored. Option C, servers have become a commodity and Microsoft doesn't even need to fix servers that fail within Azure. Option D, you can serve users better during peak traffic periods by automatically adding more capacity. The correct answers are option A, you can save money. Option D, you can serve users better during peak traffic periods by automatically adding more capacity. Elasticity in cloud computing allows you to scale resources up or down based on demand. This means you only pay for what you use, which can save you money. Additionally, elasticity helps handle peak traffic period by automatically adding more capacity when needed, ensuring optimal performance for users. Question number 97. If you wanted to get an alert every time a new virtual machine is created, where could you create that? Option A, subscription settings. Option B, Azure Monitor. Option C, Azure Policy. Option D, Azure Dashboard. The correct answer is option B, Azure Monitor. You can create an alert in Azure Monitor to notify you whenever a new virtual machine is created. Azure Monitor allows you to set up alerts based on specific activities, such as resource creation by monitoring logs and events. Question number 98. What advantage does an application gateway have over a load balancer? Option A. Application gateway understand the HTTP protocol and can interpret the URL and make decisions based on the URL. Option B. Application gateway can be scaled so that two or three or more instances of the gateway can support your application. Option C. Application gateway is more like an enterprise-grade product. You should not use a load balancer in production. The correct answer is option A. Application gateway understand the HTTP protocol and can interpret the URL and make decisions based on the URL. An application gateway operates at the application layer, layer 7, allowing it to make routine decision based on HTTP or HTTPS traffic, including the URL, host headers, or other content in the request. This is more advanced than the load balancer, which typically operates at the transport layer, layer 4, and performs load balancing based on IP addresses and ports without interpreting the application data. Question number 99. Which Azure management tool analyzes your usage of Azure and makes suggestions specifically targeted to help you optimize your usage of Azure regarding cost, security, and performance? Option A, Azure Firewall. Option B, Azure Service Health. Option C, Azure Advisor. Option D, Azure Mobile App. The correct answer is option C, Azure Advisor. Azure Advisor analyzes your Azure usage and provides personalized recommendation to help optimize cost, security, performance, and high availability. It gives actionable suggestions based on your actual usage, helping you improve your Azure environment. Question number 100. What is the goal of a DDoS attack? Option A, to crack the password from administrator accounts. Option B, to trick users into giving up personal information. Option C, to extract data from a database. Option D, to overwhelm and exhaust application resources. The correct answer is option D, to overwhelm and exhaust application resources. The goal of a DDoS, distributed denial of service attack, is to flood a target system, such as a website or application, with an overwhelming amount of traffic, exhausting its resources and making it unavailable to legitimate users.